I love a shot of the interior workings of his mind. But certainly, you know, among all of those antics last night and the trick shots and the sleeping and the talking, I mean, somehow Andy Murray did a great job keeping his composure in that match.
He did.
But I do like the fact that you could give someone else a chance. She's in excellent condition. Today will be a nice test for her in the heat of the day.
Playing better, and I'm more confident, and that's you know, that's a message to the competition.
And of course, eventually there, standing in his way, one would think, if we hold true to form, would be Novak Djokovic, and that would be a titanic test.
Yes, it would.
For Mr. Nadal, 10 doubles, and if you want to know what greatness looks like, it looks like that. Get into our American Express daily debate of who is the best up-and-comer, and we talk about anybody that could challenge Serena, that could at some point ascend to her heights. Who would it be, Pam? And Jason Goodall. And just a few moments ago, we saw Rafael Nadal out here practicing, so working on his game. And just a few hours ago, in case you were sleeping, what my friend here was referring to was Novak Djokovic entertaining the crowd after an easy win last night. He's only dropped 10 games thus far, and so nice and relaxed here, and that was evident after the match. Take a look. A few hundred fans that were there just before midnight last night, hanging in there.
Yep.
You know, it's great to see Djokovic, who understands and embraces all that it is to play at the U.S. Open, which includes a good dose of entertainment. And for a guy who used to come here years ago worrying about his allergies and such, to becoming obviously a champion here and a four-time runner-up, now he's so at home here, just the king, really, when he takes that stage.
Well, Jason, as a tennis player, that's pretty darn high level of, well, skill.
You got to love what the five-time champ has done, right? Changing the racket, changing coaches, adding this shot. So he keeps to evolve his game, and that's why he's where he is.
Weapons and attitude, big combination.
Okay, what do you think coming out of the bottom half?
I would say that Azarenka is probably your best shot, although I think Halep's playing the best tennis out of those three that you mentioned. You know, wins the Grand Slam. I'm like, wait a second, you're one of the only players that actually has a chance.